I'm Matt Bichard with REIT.com here in San Francisco for REIT World 2013. Joining me today is Dirk Allabaugh, Senior Director of Green Street Advisors Consulting Practice. Dirk, thanks so much for joining.
Thank you.
As we sit here in mid-November, 2013 has already been an eventful year for you. What do you think will be the defining story for the REIT industry?
Well, I think the defining story is really in the eye of the beholder. And the case of me, I sit in Green Street's consulting practice. We've been very active with helping some of these companies that are looking at pursuing a REIT conversion. And when the IRS put together a special committee in the spring of this year, basically halting all of those conversions, and there's literally a half a dozen companies that would make up nearly 10% of the equity market cap of the REIT industry, I think that was a defining moment, because really what it means is we may see none of those companies come to the REIT space, or we may see all six. And it's such a polarizing topic in the REIT world that we just find it incredibly interesting to see what will happen there. And I think the reality is it'll probably be somewhere between zero and six. It probably won't be six, and it won't be zero.
And now, looking ahead to 2014, what do you think is going to be the biggest challenge facing REIT management teams?
I think that's a good question. And clearly, we've seen some really strong performance from REITs, and the stocks have been trading at premiums to their net asset value, which I think is something that's been great for management teams, because they've been able to issue equity and buy properties. As we sit here today, REITs are generally trading at a discount. Not all of them, but a lot of them. And allocating capital, I think, is really going to be the challenge. And what I mean by that is it's easy to issue equity and buy properties. That's what I think it feels natural for REITs to be able to do that. In an environment where your stock's trading at a discount, what you should do, or what management teams should do, is they should sell assets and buy stock back so that they can be accretive to their shareholders and create real value by doing that. At Green Street, we preach that. It's a pretty simple concept. However, what we've seen in the past is management teams taking the bait of going out and levering up to continue to buy assets. And in our opinion, the management teams that don't take that bait are the ones that are going to win in the eyes of investors.
And lastly, is there a sector or segment of the REIT market that you think might surprise shareholders or analysts in the coming year?
Sure. I think there's a number of sectors that could do well depending on what happens with the economy, but one that I think is particularly interesting is the multifamily space. The stocks have been trading at a discount to NAV for nearly a year, if not over a year. And I think that the development pipelines, while they're there, and it's pretty clear that they got out of the chute early with the Great Recession on the development. However, I think it's really just pockets of the country where that development is potentially going to affect demand. Generally, though, I think there's real good opportunity if we see the strong job growth that we've seen recently. If that continues for the coming years, I think multifamily has the potential to outperform in terms of NOI growth.
Well, Dirk, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
For more on this and other REIT news and analysis, be sure to visit REIT.com.